1949 Project Twinkle and Green Fireballs Part 4. Conclusions. Undoubtedly, a good many of the observations reported are attributable to ordinary man-made objects such as airplanes, balloons, smoke rockets, and more. It appears that balloon observations especially are responsible for a large number of the reports. The possibility of small emissive clouds issuing from atomic installations also has been proposed. Many of the sightings are attributable to natural phenomena such as flight of birds, planets, meteors, and possibly cloudiness. Dr. Fred L. Whipple of Harvard, in a memorandum to this laboratory dated the 9th of August 1950 relative to this problem, indicated that he had observed a tendency for the occurrence of small detached clouds in New Mexico, which might have been mistaken for an aerial object when illuminated by the reflected light of the moon. Dr. Whipple investigated the possibility of a correlation between the frequency of aerial phenomena observations and weather conditions, specifically cloudiness. A rough analysis of available weather data indicated that on the 53 nights between the 5th of December 1948 and the 5th of March 1951, when observations were reported, 10 were clear, 24 partially cloudy, 5 completely overcast, and 14 had no record. The number of cloudy nights involved seems unusually high for New Mexico. The weather reports were for the Las Cruces area only, whereas many of the observations were a considerable distance from Las Cruces. Further investigation is therefore necessary to determine correlations with cloudiness. Dr. Whipple also conducted a study as to whether the age of the moon was related to the frequency of aerial phenomena observations. The results did not indicate that the phenomena were observed largely at full moon. The statistics show that of the 72 observations reported, 45 occurred when the moon was up and 27 when it was down, with many of the observations occurring at the time of the moon's first quarter. From the statistical study, Dr. Whipple suggests that the existence of moonlight is correlated with the phenomena. Dr. Whipple's frequency diagram of observations versus age of moon is included in this report. It should be noted that Dr. Whipple made a careful study of meteor photographs taken in New Mexico on 35 nights when observations were reported. None of the photographs revealed the presence of unusual sky phenomena. Finally, the overall picture obtained from the year of vigilance and inquiry does not permit a conclusive opinion concerning the aerial phenomena of interest. The comparatively high incidence of the phenomena since 1948 does not necessarily indicate that the objects are man-made. It is conceivable that the Earth may be passing through a region in space of high meteoric population. Also, the sunspot maxima in 1948 perhaps in some way may be a contributing factor. Recommendations. Since the findings to date cannot be considered conclusive, it appears that the following recommendations would be pertinent. No further fiscal expenditure be made in pursuing the problem. This opinion is prompted partly by the fruitless expenditure during the past year, the uncertainty of existence of unexplainable aerial objects, and by the inactive position currently taken by Holloman AFB as indicated by the standby status of the project. The arrangements by HAFB for continued vigilance by Landair, the weather station, as well as the briefing of pilots on the problem in part relieves the need for a systematic instrumentation program. Within the next few months, Dr. Whipple will have completed the installation of two 18-inch Schmidt cameras for meteor studies. The cameras will be stationed about 20 miles apart in the vicinity of Las Cruces, New Mexico. Since these studies will be sponsored by the GOD, arrangements can be made for examining the film for evidence of aerial object phenomena.